So we did a piece yesterday and we had leftover colors. So I just, all the time, I'll pour them on a tile just to see what they would do together. And this is what happened. And I really liked it, so I feel like I wanna do a bigger one. So I'm gonna try to do this on this. But anybody that works with resin will tell you. 11 by 14. Trying to recreate anything with resin is basically impossible. We're gonna give it a shot. YOLO.
Nobody says that anymore.
But I did.
But
he's a hater.
Maybe a 14-year-old.
Well, you don't like it. Just plug your ears next time. I don't know what to tell you. What's funny? Why am I funny?
Why are you looking at me? Look at the camera.
Because you're over there. Put the camera in front of your face. We're gonna do this double angle?
Yeah.
I hope it turns out right. We're doing all this. I'm really nervous about trying to recreate something because it never, like ever,
well,
never.
You should
ever.
Be nervous because it's never gonna turn out the same.
Such
you know
a positive
that.
Thinker. I think that's why I love you. If I say yellow again, would you want me to bleep it out? In the video? In the video? Normal. Okay, I'll reuse it. So now I have my even resin. That was chunky. Every time we get the resin out, I'm like, should we weigh it and see if it weighs the same? But then I forget. So B, do you think it'll turn out the same or no?
I think it'll have the same colors.
It's like the only thing that we can, like, control. Control. Since this is like a reused thing, I keep trying to like get the resin off that's already hardened. But I can't get that off. It's already on there for life.
Vic just texted me. Vic. V-I-C.
What's that?
Look at this. Don't look at me. Cause...
Resin. All the bubbles. What did they say?
I don't know. I'm recording.
Oh, I thought it showed you like two lines of... Since it's usually my job to go over what colors we're using, you wanna?
Nope. Try these guys.
You used both of these? Oh yeah, you did. This one's still spongy on this side. By the way, it's a nice brisk, probably 35 degrees out, and I should have warmed this up.
Yeah, she always does the shoulda, coulda, woulda. This is Dallas. This was Dallas all day yesterday and
until
last
like
night, and now it's...
Storm did.
beautiful outside. Art shot. Yeah, we live across the street from the police department. Can't tell. In downtown.
He's grinding.
All of our spray paint. Excuse me. It's pretty much my section. The airbrush section. Trashed.
Stop being trashy.
Trashed. I get to use this guy next week. Excited.
I'm gonna say that one's the dark blue. And one of these is the gold and one of these is the light blue. Get every drop out of there. So I'm gonna do a dirty pour, but I think if I poured all these into this cup, I'm gonna waste a lot of resin trying to pour it out. So we're just gonna cut this down. Hopefully I don't cut it down too small. You live and you learn. Also yellow. That's for him. Okay. So now, I don't remember the exact order I poured this in or what was the most or least or whatever, so we're just gonna go for it. Put some white in there. Blue in there. They are such different consistencies. I hope it turns out beautiful. But yeah, I'm about to do it. About to put it on it. I'm scared. Okay. So it looks, focus, looks like this. I'm scared, okay. Looks like I didn't quite make enough. Why does it always look so pretty in the cup? So what I'm gonna do to help it spread easier is put some of this on it. Oh my God, it's gonna look nothing like my original. Prep this canvas, but it's still dipping just slightly. Put more down there, but I don't want to ruin this. Is my favorite part. So I don't know what to do with it.
Just mix white. Just mix. Just make some. Just make some more. Put white in it and just go around this whole edge and then just blend it together.
That blue. Would blue work? Do you want to use white?
This is not mine. This is yours. It looks like it looks very I don't know. It's hard to like these colors. They go well together. It's just very different.
Very like Indian culture. Like all the bright colors. Maybe it'll settle pretty.
That looks amazing.
Thanks. I feel like I should put something in here. Or should I heat it and rotate it? I don't want to wreck it.
Well, it's going to continue to blend and move and you just heat all this stuff real quick so then it look at it moving. All the air bubbles.
I wouldn't mind rotate. It's the same reason why I get frustrated with acrylic is because if I move it, my favorite parts are gonna go away. And is it worth the risk? We're gonna have people on our page like, why did you touch it? Or is it gonna come out something amazing? And
well, the thing is, where are you gonna set this?
In our super secret protector shed. Like this, I don't even know what's happening, but I love that. And this, bang. This like, I don't even know what it is. It's like, have you ever shined like a light into a leaf and seen all the like leaf veins? That's what all this reminds me of. That's cellular, like not cells that people want, but like science cells. Yeah, if I move it at all, it's gonna. Like that part. This part, this like gold ocean wave thing going on, love it. This part, I don't know about all this over here though, but it's an interesting piece. So this is how this piece turned out. Focus. Still, that part looks like I like it. This part is interesting. Probably some of my favorite parts are like these parts. I don't know, it's so touch and go for me with dirty pores. It's the same reason why I'm horrible at acrylic pores, because I don't know what I'm doing, basically, to sum it up. But it looks interesting. It looks to me like a splash. Like I almost want to go in and, like blacken out some of it so it actually looks like kind of like splash, like if there was a big rock here. I don't know. I'm probably just thinking too much. Anyways, this is what it looks like. I'm definitely gonna try to do it again, but like puddle style and not a dirty pour, I think. Yeah.